four, three, two, one. We are live!
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and fans around the world. Welcome to the Calgary Pavilion. Welcome to the Toronto Pavilion. And welcome to Dungeon Wrestling. This is the first time that Dungeon Wrestling is on pay-per-view. And we want to thank you so much for being here. We have to ask our ring announcer here to give us a chance to talk, but in the meantime, my name is Mike McGuire. This is Dimitri Karolis, and this is Mitch Hodges. You'll get to know all of us here tonight, but most importantly, we are so happy to be here with you for this historic return to the Pavilion Broadcasting Wrestling here tonight. Let's take you to the ring. Our first contest is ready to go underway as tonight we are going to see the reinstatement of a legendary championship from this city, from this company, from this legacy. Gentlemen, let me ask you right now, how are you feeling about the return of the World Mid-Heavyweight Championship?
I'm gonna tell you right now, Mike, it has been a long time coming, not just from the generational gap between the new promotion at Dungeon Wrestling, but to crown that new champion and to see who's gonna take us to the next level.
This is what it's all about. I love it. Listen to the enthusiasm in the crowd and everyone here. This is exciting stuff.
Shaun Moore making his way into the ring right now. For those not familiar, Shaun Moore has an amateur wrestling background. He had an incredible match here last time at Dungeon Wrestling against Cutthroat Chris Knight. That match actually went to a 15-minute draw, though. Let's take him back to the ring now to find out his opponent.
Got to do, if that don't work, then kick the facts. If you a fighter, ride a bada, flame ignite a crowd, excite a hole, you wanna just get hot and just say it. But then if you a lie,
and your current World Mid-Heavyweight Champion, weighing in at 195 pounds and fighting out of Calgary, Alberta.
A misstep there from a ring announcer here. Just to know, Mo Jabari, not the mid-heavyweight champion yet, but he could be after this match tonight, as both men are competing to reinstate the title here. Mo Jabari, definitely a local favorite here.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, the way the crowd is reacting, he looks to be the favorite in my book.
Listen, this is wrestling. Last time I heard, it's not a popularity contest. I'm going with the man that looks like he's ready to kill everybody.
Well, very interesting road for Mo Jabari to get to this contest. He's had a couple of matches that have actually ended in disqualification, but in his favor against Crimson, who we will see later tonight on the card as well. And safe to say, this is definitely a place where Mo Jabari wants to be, but I don't think it's how he wanted to get here with two disqualification wins bringing him to this contest.
That's a great point, Mike. You know, judging what happened with Crimson, I'm surprised he's even A back in the first place. But what I respect about Jabari, he's accepting every challenge, taking the hard right throw.
As you can tell, Jabari a fan favorite. What you may not know about Mo Jabari, though, you can see a definite influence in his gear and in his wrestling style, paying not just tribute to Bret the Hitman Hart,
Patrick!
As we find out, Michael Fitzpatrick, the referee for this contest here again, you might notice a very heavy Bret the Hitman Hart influence on Jabari.
One fall or a 20-minute limit.
And again, Jabari, not just a fan, but actually a bit of a protege of the Hitman, finding himself in this match tonight.
What do we got here?
Well, just a second. My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. Cutthroat Chris Knight again, who's the man that went to a draw with Shaun Moore last time we were here at the Victoria Pavilion.
Yeah, well, there's another thing I noticed is that flask in hand. It seems like he didn't finish that.
Well, I mean, he's here. He's taking a look. He wants to see what's happening. I don't blame the guy.
He swears it's just a sports drink.
Last show, Doomsday, me and this scumbag had a match. You couldn't beat me, Sunshine, could ya? You couldn't beat me, could ya? So I ask this, why is this scumbag in the ring with a championship shot? See that is money. That championship belt is money for me. So, shut up, hold your horses, I'm not done. Shut up.
A little respect here, let the guy talk.
I'm not done, hold your horses. So there's only one logical thing to do, and that's you better put me in this match, because I got to make money. Sunshine, put me in the match.
Well, I don't know what Chris Knight's point is here. The championship committee.
What does he think he's doing?
The championship committee voted that these two were the best to contend for the return of the World Mid Heavyweight Championship.
I think we're going to have a change.
I agree, Mike. He had his shot.
No, he didn't beat him last time, though, Mike.
Wait a minute now.
What are you doing? You can't.
What does this guy want now? Michael Blaze, a running mate of Chris Knight's, is out.
I get it. I understand. Chris Knight, you're right. This guy couldn't beat you. He doesn't deserve a title match. Maybe you should be in this match. But if you're in this match, then who does Michael Richard Blaze wrestle on this show?
That's right.
You
can't
have
a contest
dungeon wrestling without God's gift to wrestling. So if you think you're going to be in this match, I need a match too. So I guess Michael Richard Blaze is in this match too.
Well, an interesting turn of events here, gentlemen, as it appears Michael Richard Blaze
Ladies
wants to make this.
Looks like we have a bit of a disagreement here.
What's going to happen? This is supposed to be a championship match.
This is just selfish.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Kid Chocolate and Shaun Moore are going to challenge Chris Cutthroat Knight and the God's Gift to Wrestling, Michael Blaze, to a tag team match.
This is interesting. I like
it. It's going to be a tag team match, and these guys are going to wipe the floor with those guys.
Well, fans, it appears as though our quest
so
to
ladies and gentlemen, the challengers, weighing in at 246 pounds, from Melbourne, Australia, Chris Cutthroat Knight!
And here we were just about to unveil the new championship. Unbelievable.
And from Edmonton, God's Gift to Wrestling at 200 pounds, Michael Blaze! I'm going to bring you to it, I'm out of here.
All right, fans, well, here we go. We now have our opening contest, a tag team match between two men who were set to face each other tonight in Shaun Moore and Kid Chocolate Mo Jabari, taking on Cutthroat Chris Knight and God's Gift to Wrestling, as he calls himself, Michael Richard Blaze. Now, all four of these men definitely find contenders. And you know what? As much as I hate to say it, Chris Knight might have a point. He didn't actually lose a match against Shaun Moore. So I guess we're going to see what he has to offer tonight.
That's exactly what I was saying myself. This is should be at most a three-way. Ah, it's a tag. Yeah, we'll take it.
Yeah.
Well, here we go. Collar and elbow tie-up now between Jabari and Blaze in center of the ring. Both men trying to power through. And Jabari managed to switch around in the corner. And referee Michael Fitzpatrick getting in the middle to get a clean break between the two. But Blaze decides to shove out immediately. Jabari having none of that, though. And both men tie up once again. This time go behind from Jabari. Reversal from Blaze, takedown, head scissor, and both men are back up.
I am seeing a lot more aggressiveness already from Jabari. Could be the experience from those matches with Crimson.
Well, he definitely does have a lot harder edge than he did before, especially after those encounters with Crimson. They've definitely toughened up Jabari, but the question is he going to get any sort of momentum coming out of this match, moving towards what will eventually be the crowning of a world mid-heavyweight champion?
Whether you like it or hate it, I mean, you do got to respect Michael Blaze in the ring.
Quick turnaround now from Jabari, gets on top.
I just don't see how Moore and Jabari can work together. They were about to fight each other, and now they got to team up together. I don't get it. I don't see this working out in their way.
Well, this is sportsmanship, though, Mitch, and sometimes you have to realize there's a greater good, and that is to prove that you belong where you are in a contendership match. And that's, I think, what Jabari and Moore have on the line tonight in this match, is to prove that they deserve that opportunity.
Yeah, don't worry, Mike. You know, we have our problems here with what we think is too many men in the room.
Shoulder block now for Blaze. Follows up with another on Jabari. Goes for three, but this time drop toe hold from Jabari. Swings around once again. Gets reverse lock now. Side chin lock by Jabari.
He has that locked in very deep.
Blaze trying to get up. Both men on their feet. Hair pull out of the sight of the referee, though. And this time, Jabari hits with a shoulder block of his own. Follows up with another. Jabari pushed through the ropes by Blaze, but Jabari back up. Over the top, sunset flip gets him over. One, two, just a two. Shoulders down now. Two count, shoulders down again. These two men reversing. Big bridge from Jabari. Both men battling for a backslide. Blaze swings Jabari around off the ropes, follows him in. This is the drop kick as Jabari holds the top rope. Going for the sharpshooter now is Jabari.
Blaze able to fight that off very quickly. He knows. He knows that's not a position you want to be in.
Smart move by Blaze, getting to the corner, getting to his tag partner. Jabari now just waiting. Asking the fans if they want Shaun Moore tagged in. Teamwork on both sides, if you want to call it that, is both Jabari and Blaze kind of reluctant to tag in their partners.
There you go.
Now it's two powerhouses. Fisticuffs galore between Moore and Knight. Moore whipping Knight off the ropes, drop down. Leapfrog over top, big drop kick from Moore. And it's all Shaun Moore on Cutthroat Chris Knight.
That's aggressive behavior. I like this. I like this Shaun Moore. I like this guy.
Well, if you're looking for aggression, you've come to the right place in Dungeon Wrestling as Shaun Moore takes Cutthroat Chris Knight to the outside. And don't be fooled, because Chris Knight back in the ring. Double leg takedown, series of fists, closed fists. Referee needs to get in on that, but Shaun Moore gets in with his. And both men are back up, but no stop on either of these guys. As Shaun Moore continues with the right hands, knocking Knight over the top rope to the outside again.
Shaun Moore is, you can see, is not happy that he has to be in this situation, that is for sure, and he is taking it out on Chris Knight.
The happiest guy is Mo Jabari going, oh my God, I almost had to fight this guy.
Shaun Moore now calling for it. Off the ropes, gets stopped by Michael Blaze. What was going to be a tope to the outside. Knight getting in there. And those aren't soft padded boots, friends. Those are hiking boots. This guy is raised in the outback. He doesn't really have what we would call conventional wrestling gear.
I don't think he's ever taken those things off.
That's up to be debated, but as we continue now, there's a tag. And it's Michael Blaze. With Shaun Moore in the corner.
What teamwork. What teamwork by these two guys. Excellent work.
Referee now being distracted by Blaze as Knight gets the chin lock in. And that's almost a chokehold. Jabari sees it, but now referee Michael Fitzpatrick not seeing what's going on.
I can't say I like what I'm doing, but at the same time, they're working well as a team here.
Well, you can work well if the referee's not paying attention. You can do whatever you want as Shaun Moore is in worse for wear condition. Big right hand from Knight in the corner.
5 minutes gone.
Now we get a series of blows to the back of Shaun Moore. What's Knight got planned here? Hanging Moore on the top rope. Pushes him down. Wait a second. He's pulling that shin down. Oh, he's just holding him so he couldn't get around anywhere. That way, I guess Shaun Moore wouldn't be able to steady himself and fight back should Knight get to the floor late.
It's a good point. There's no way for him to reset. Definitely capitalizing on the opportunity here. Tag made.
Look at the synergy between these two working together. Beautifully done, gentlemen.
Well, so far, great to say that, Mitch, is Michael Richard Blaze now drives the knee into the back of Shaun Moore. Whip into the corner once again. Shaun Moore finds himself in territory he does not want to be in. Double foot stomp from Blaze. Tag. Brings in the big man, Cutthroat Chris Knight once again.
He's got him right where he wants him, in the center of the ring.
Mo Jabari, we see, trying to rally the fans behind Shaun Moore. Chris Knight doing a good job of cutting off the ring. Forearm smash again to the back, but now a shot to the midsection by Moore on Knight. Continued exchange of forearm blows and midsection shots. Shaun Moore on his feet and gets a tag! Jabari jumps all over the top and follows with a clothesline. Inverted atomic drop. Russian leg sweep. And Jabari's in control. Spinning kick to the midsection, off the ropes now. And Blaze once again. Causes a stop to the momentum of Mo Jabari and Shaun Moore.
Teamwork. All about teamwork.
They are wearing these guys down. Even Shaun Moore slow to get up, even though he's been out of the ring.
Big body slam from Knight, sees him tag his partner in, and now it's Michael Blaze working on the lower back of Mo Jabari. And for those that don't know much about Michael Richard Blaze, considers himself a bit of a leader. Some would say almost a cult leader, in the sense of trying to show people the clandestine way in pro wrestling, which is his way or no way, even though he finds himself teaming up with Cutthroat Chris Knight tonight.
So far, I've seen him a couple of times now. The God's gift is a real thing. Like, he is smart, ambitious. He knows what he's doing, Mike. I love this guy.
Well, right now, Mo Jabari knows what Michael Blaze is doing, and that's driving him into the turnbuckle. European uppercut. But this is the thing. You can't take your time. We've seen Blaze have this problem before. If you follow Dungeon Wrestling on YouTube, you've seen Blaze get distracted in his own mind. And once again, a momentary delay is costing him. But Cutthroat Chris Knight making the save.
But this time the ref has at least seen it. Come on, let's do something here.
I don't know why referee Michael Fitzpatrick is allowing this to happen at all. It's in a neutral corner. Now we get the tag, and Chris Knight is back in.
You try controlling these beasts.
I'd like to control
you.
No,
thank you, sir. I'm right out here, and I'm happy that way.
Jabari just on instinct right now.
Going up top, high rent district. What's Jabari got planned? Mitchell drop kick.
He's got to make a cover here. He can't take his time like you said, Mike.
Wait a minute, where's Blaze going? Blaze now. Oh my goodness. Moore's leg got hooked in the steps, the ringside steps here. Hopefully we can get a shot, but.
He's holding his shin. He's holding his knee, in fact.
Shaun Moore now in rough shape on the outside, his foot getting caught in the ring steps. We go back to the action inside the ring. And Michael Blaze back in. Legs of Mo Jabari being held down by Chris Knight. And now it's Blaze going for the count, shoulders down for two. And there you can see Shaun Moore nursing that leg that went through the ring steps.
You may not like it, but that is a brilliant move by Blaze. And look at now he's made it a handicap match.
Yeah, well, you might just got what you wished for, Mitch, in a two-on-one, or your version of a triple threat.
Jabari off the ropes now. Spine buster from Blaze. Hooks the leg for two. Blaze stunned that he didn't get the three count on that. Shaun Moore climbing back up to his position at ringside, though. Surprisingly, he is very tenderly watching that right leg of his that went through the ring steps, but.
Even if he makes the tag, at this point, how effective is he going to be?
Well, we'll see what happens. These wrestlers live to recover off adrenaline to try and win the match, but right now, look at this. The face of Jabari just getting pried apart by Michael Blaze.
He's just trying to help him look better.
Blocks the right hand now from Blaze as Jabari trying to fight his way out of the enemy's corner. Jabari with another right hand, trying to stabilize himself using the top rope, spinning heel kick. Jabari with a drop kick straight to the side of the head of Blaze.
Spun him around midair. Wow.
Shaun Moore on the apron, trying to get the support of this crowd. Mo Jabari trying to get to his tag team partner, but he might as well be a mile away. Chris Knight comes in, wait a minute, tripped over the ropes. This time leaping off of Chris Knight goes Moore. Shaun Moore exploding all over Blaze and Knight. Lifts Michael Blaze to the top turnbuckle. Beautiful drop kick to the top rope and beyond.
He's looking for more.
Shaun Moore cross body from the top. Why does he go for the cover? Straps up just to go straps down. I think he knows that Blaze is the legal man. I'm getting confused in all this, but here we go. Beautiful. One, two, only two. No, it was only two. It was only a two count. The music guy getting a little excited here.
That's how close it was, and I gotta be honest, I think I side with the music guy. How'd he kick out?
He kicked out. You know, you can't, as much as I don't agree with what Michael Blaze might be as a person outside of the ring, inside the ring, he's a competitor. Wait a minute. Wait just a minute.
Why can't the ref control this?
We're setting this up right now. Shaun Moore holding up Chris Knight. That's not an easy task. Big flying elbow off the top from Jabari. Blaze missing with a double clothesline. Gets dropped for his purpose, and now it's Shaun Moore on the outside on Knight inside the ring. Schoolboy roll up from Blaze on Kid Chocolate. Wait, foot on the ropes. And fortunately,
there we go.
Referee Michael Fitzpatrick sees it. Breaks up the count.
Jabari waiting.
Outside the ring, we see Chris Knight and Shaun Moore, but wait a minute. Beautiful face buster by Jabari.
Talk about hometown bias. Even the referee's helping out the guy now.
I don't think Fitzpatrick's from Calgary.
Everyone loves him here, I'm just saying.
Here we go, Jabari from the top. Big elbow drop. This could be it. 1, 2, 3. Mo Jabari and Shaun Moore, a couple of men who were set to square off tonight to crown a new mid-heavyweight world champion. But now,
I am not gonna lie, I was disappointed that we couldn't get that title match. However, after seeing what we just saw, that sentiment is mostly gone.
They stand as victors together tonight, but there's no doubt in my mind we might see these guys squaring off against each other down the road once again. And it could be with the World Mid-Heavyweight Championship on the line here in Dungeon Wrestling.
I do agree with Dimitri. I'm disappointed we couldn't see these two one-on-one. But I'll say one thing, this Shaun Moore, I like the cut of this jib. I like this guy.
Yeah, you can't deny he's a hell of a competitor.
Well, both men now inside the ring agree to shake hands. Maybe better luck next time. As we get ready for lots more action. Shaun Moore telling us as he walked by the commentary, this is his time and his title. We'll see what happens.
It'll be interesting to see what happens, because before they were going in blind, but now they've teamed up and they've seen each other in the ring. It's only gonna help in their arsenal.
Fans, we want to welcome you again to Dungeon Wrestling, our initial pay-per-view, our inaugural pay-per-view.